Silkworm farming can be a unique and profitable business venture if properly planned and maintained with proper training. Silk produced from silkworms is a high-demand, luxury fabric used in fashion, textiles, and home decoration. Consistent global demand provides stable revenue streams. Silkworm farming is a valuable source of livelihood for rural farmers. Sericulture can be easily started by men as well as women, thereby contributing to the economic empowerment of women and promoting gender equality in rural areas. Silkworm farming requires relatively low capital investment compared to other farming activities, making it accessible to small-scale farmers. Dear visitors, today we will try to tell you how to make the sericulture business profitable and cheap. Moreover, its advantages and disadvantages. The cultivation of silkworms to produce silk yarn is called sericulture. It is one of the oldest industries, through which silk thread is extracted from the cocoons of silkworms. Silk cultivation primarily requires moth eggs, mulberry leaves as raw material, and special care. For sericulture, mulberry trees must first be planted from which mulberry leaves can be collected. Silkworms feed on the leaves of the mulberry tree, so it is important to cultivate this tree. The leaves of this plant should be stored in a cool and shaded place to keep them fresh. Silkworms are initially in egg form. Eggs need to be kept at a certain temperature for larvae to hatch. After hatching, the larvae should be fed with fresh mulberry leaves. Silkworms usually grow best at 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. Humidity should be 65 to 70%. Cultivation of silkworms should be done in a clean, well-ventilated area and away from sunlight. After silkworms feed on leaves for 30 to 35 days, they form a cocoon. A cocoon takes about 2 to 3 days to form. The cocoons are collected and silk thread is made from them. To extract the silk thread from the cocoons are first boiled in hot water. Boiling softens the cocoon silk protein, called sericin, and separates the fibers. By doing this, it becomes easier to remove the thread from the cocoon. After boiling in hot water, the silk thread from the cocoon is pulled out by hand or with a special machine. This process is called reeling. About 300 to 900 meters long yarn is obtained from a cocoon. These silk yarns are very thin, so multiple yarns are blended to make a strong yarn. After reeling, the yarns are kept dry. Cleaning and drying reveal the natural color and texture of the yarn. Silk yarn is often dyed, making it attractive for use in cloth making or other purposes. A combination of these methods is shown from sericulture to the production of silk yarn, which is then used to make various types of cloth, saris, garments, or other products.